truly unlike any other non-organic life form, thanks to her unorthodox makeup of astromech and protocol droid components, L3-37 was humanoid in both shape and speech. However, she could outwalk and outtalk any regular R-series unit, and while her self-made, non-factory tested form led to the occasional breakdown, resulting in physical adjustment of the circuits in her back from Lando Calrissian, L3 was an enlightened navigator. So much so that by directly interfacing with the Millennium Falcon state-of-the-art Navi computer, she allowed the ship to reach unparalleled superlight speeds. Moreover, she calculated complex hyperspace routes that halved the distances usually travelled by, well, let's just say, more cautious crafts. During these very voyages, Calrissian's fast reflex manoeuvres at sublight made him the ideal co-pilot, but that's not to say that L3 was incapable of mirroring such actions all by herself. Having begun life inside an R3 astromech droid, L3's brain module was overlaid with data architecture from an espionage unit, and while it also came equipped with protocol droid processors allowing her to analyse organic behaviour, she lacked tran-line communications, thus reducing her abilities as an interpreter. Furthermore, L3 was left with a deeply self-aware consciousness that completely rejected the galaxy's systematic oppression against mechanical intelligence, given the ultra-modern custom coding of her brain module, often calling for a droid revolution as a result. She longed for the day where mechanicals threw off their shackles and determined their own fates. With a need to share her insight and independence across all droid kind, not to mention her determined and strong-headed attitude, L3 often unsettled any organic she came into contact with. But what do you make of her character? And how do you think she compares to the likes of C-3PO, RTD2, Chopper, and K2SO? Let me know in the comments below. If you've learned something new from today's video, be sure to leave a like. To help out the channel that little bit extra, please do consider pledging to our Patreon page, and for weekly content on all things Han Solo, press that subscribe button and notification bell to keep it locked here to the Kangaroo Sands.